Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, everyone. Thank you for joining us today for our introduction to gyroMWD webinar. I just want to start off with a little bit of a brag on our safety culture at Scientific Drilling. One of the things that we pride ourselves on is being focused on safety and making sure that we're safe at work and safe at home, and everyone goes home safe. So much so that for those of you that were able to see the screen just a little while ago, we had our most recent safety stat up, and that is that we've been, at this point, over 14 months without a recordable incident, which brings our TRIR to zero. Very proud of this stat, and we're working hard to make sure that we stay there. We are recording the webinar this morning, so it will be available for you to view later on this week, or actually, it'll be available for you to view next week, I'm sorry. Whenever we're going through the webinar, if you have questions, feel free to post those in the chat. We will be monitoring. We will have a question and answer session when Laura is done, and she'll answer most of your questions. So if you want to hold off and ask those during the question and answer session, feel free. If you'd like to post them in the chat during the webinar, we'll monitor those and make sure they get answered. And with that, I will turn it over to Ms. Laura Perry.
Thank you, Ben. Okay, hi, everyone. First of all, thank you very much for joining us today for this introduction to gyroMWD webinar. I'll start with a brief introduction to myself. My name is Laura Pirre, and I'm the Global Product Line Engineer for gyroMWD for Scientific Drilling. So I started my career in the industry with Scientific Drilling after graduating from the University of Glasgow with a degree in physics and mathematics, and also completing a master's in oil and gas engineering at the Robert Gordon University in Aberdeen in Scotland. So I started with Scientific in 2009 as a field engineer in our Aberdeen district office in the UK. And there I was predominantly involved in running gyroMWD and wireline conveyed gyro services in areas such as the North Sea, Norway and the Caspian. Back in 2014, I transferred to Scientific Drilling's Applied Technology Center, which is based in Paso Robles, California, and that's where our gyro manufacturing and engineering takes place. So I'm responsible for overseeing all current gyroMWD services offered by Scientific Drilling and in the development of new gyroMWD technologies. So this webinar is designed to provide an introduction to gyroMWD and its application in directional wellbore surveying. So I'll start by explaining the requirement for gyroMWD, how the system works, and some typical applications. And at the end there, I'll get into a couple of case studies so you can see where we're operating globally and the kind of operations that we're involved in. So starting here with the importance of directional wellbore surveying, while drilling, accurate directional survey data is required in order to maintain the proposed well path, which will enable precise wellbore placement and is required to obtain a target bottom hole position. It's important at all times to know the wellbore path, both in the construction of the well and for relief well planning. So while drilling, survey data, which consists of a measure depth, inclination and azimuth as discrete measurement points, are combined with the known start position and direction to create a calculated wellbore survey, typically using the minimum curvature method to create the well path and position in terms of true vertical depth, northings and eastings. So shown on this slide are some wells drilled from man-made islands in Long Beach, California. And these pictures came from a presentation which was given to the Industry Steering Committee on Wellbore Survey Accuracy by OXE back in 2014. So as you can see in the top graphic, the target is 4,000 feet below the city of Long Beach, and the well is drilled from an offshore island there. And shown below that is a very busy graphic of wells to be drilled from those offshore islands and a couple of onshore locations as well. So as we focus deeper into one of those islands and the well bores below it, we see the proposed well in blue, and as you can see, it's navigating through a vast number of offset wells in its planned trajectory. So wellbores are complex in their trajectory, and in order to maximize spacing available, are often required to be drilled in close proximity to offset wellbores. And this is where gyroMWD primarily comes in. MWD packages consisting of magnetic sensors are unable to provide accurate directional survey data in terms of azimuth when close to the casing of an offset well. This is because the magnetic interference from those casing strings will affect the magnetic sensor, whereas a gyroscopic sensor is unaffected by magnetic interference in any way. So clearly magnetic interference would be experienced in this situation in a congested pad or field, and especially where the surface footprint would be small. So for example, in an offshore platform drilling situation or onshore pad drilling. Furthermore, once a hole section is drilled in the current well and cased, magnetic interference would be present at the casing exit when you're drilling out the following hole section. And that's because the BHA would be inside or close to casing at that exit point. An accurate survey data would be required at the casing exit such that the BHA can be steered appropriately, avoiding collision with any offset well, but also importantly, kicking off in the right direction for the planned trajectory. So other typical applications, again, where magnetic interference is present, would be setting a whipstock inside casing. So again, your MWD sensor is inside casing, unable to provide accurate data, and a gyroscopic sensor can be used to provide the accurate directional survey data and also a steering tool face at low inclination such that whipstock can be set accurately inside casing. So gyroMWD is a directional sensor package, and it's housed in the bottom hole assembly and is capable of providing accurate directional and steering data. As part of the downhole drilling assembly, the gyroMWD tool provides this data without the need to run a dedicated wireline or slickline conveyed gyro tool. So there are a number of different configurations of the tool, either using mud pulse telemetry, and this would be where the data is transmitted to surface via the fluid system, or using electromagnetic telemetry, and that's where the data is transmitted through an electromagnetic signal in the formation, and that would be independent of the mud flow. Scientific drilling gyroMWD tools are also compatible with a number of third-party MWD providers tools. And in this case, we are physically connected to those third-party providers' tools, and the data telemetry is transmitted via their telemetry. So that means that we can run in the same BHA with another provider's MWD, LWD, or rotary steerable systems. On this slide, tandem telemetry refers to applications where there is more than one telemetry path while drilling. So for example, we would have scientific gyroMWD using mud pulse telemetry at a known frequency, which would be pulsing data uphole at the same time as a secondary third-party MWD provider's tool. So we've got two mud pulse signals coming uphole, but the tool signals are discrete from each other and do not affect each other, which allows both to be decoded on surface. And we have many applications of running this tool in our standalone mud pulse and EM systems, along with our third-party modules, and again with that tandem telemetry. So this flexibility in the running configurations available enables providers or MWD providers who do not have a gyroMWD technology to include a gyroscopic sensor in their downhole drilling assembly. So the gyroMWD tool is a probe-based tool, and it's powered by a 36-volt lithium battery and housed in a non-mag drill collar installed in the BHA. So you can see from the graphic there's resizable rubber fins, and this means that the tool is compatible with all collar sizes. And as I said, it can be added to any BHA consisting of any number of other MWD magnetic sensors or logging while drilling, such as gamma, pressure while drilling, resistivity, and also compatible there with rotary steerable systems. So where a gyroMWD tool is required, the tool is activated by the shut off or start up of the rig mud pumps. So during a gyro survey, the BHA must remain completely stationary with no flow for the duration of the survey. So typically for operational efficiency, we'll take these surveys over connections, since those two conditions are already met at that time. You have stationary BHA downhole and you're disconnected from the top drive with pumps off. Although we can take a survey at any point, any mid-stand survey point, just by following the process of stationary BHA and no pumps. So this slide just shows you here the survey process. So I'll just run through it, how the tool operates downhole. So once a single or a stand has been drilled down to depth and picked up off bottom, the pumps are turned off there, either for the connection or the survey, as I said, and the gyroMWD tool will detect that the movement has stopped, and that is what activates the survey process. So we have X and Z gyros that spin up to 42,000 RPM and they'll check for a gyro sync. The tool will then begin a four position gyro compass measurement. And in doing that, it slews between four positions, which are offset by 90 degrees, and it collects data at each of those stations. Finally, a Z gyro drift check is performed, and that measures the gyro drift over a set period. Gyro drift stability, and that's a quality assurance for using gyro tool face to steer at low inclination. So the data is then stored to the tool memory and it's transmitted to surface either immediately if you're using electromagnetic telemetry, since that doesn't rely on the pumps in any way, or the next time the pumps come on if we're using mud pulse telemetry. Again, either via our mud pulse telemetry or our third party compatible tools. So at this point, data received from the tool includes an inclination and an azimuth, as well as a number of quality assurance values which help us determine the accuracy of the measurement. So while drilling ahead with pumps on, the gyroMWD tool will provide an accurate gyro tool face for steering at low inclination. Now, scientific drilling started offering gyroMWD services in 2000, and the technology has been used to drill thousands of well bores globally. So this map is by no means exhaustive, and if I've missed an area, I apologize, but I just wanted to show the variety of operations and areas and environments in which we have run this tool. We have high latitude applications in Alaska and Norway. We have offshore applications on every rig type, from semi-subs, drill ships, jackups and platforms, and land-based applications on pad drilling across US land and other countries and continents also. So again, the main reasons to run gyroMWD would be for anti-collision, casing exit, whipstock orientation. And more and more, we see gyroMWD run as a means of survey validation. So that's where we're taking downhole. We have both a magnetic and a gyro sensor, and we get survey data from both of those tools, two independent sensors downhole, and that allows us to validate each sensor against each other. So the tool is very reliable. We have a 98.8% success rate. There's scarcely a week in the calendar year, actually, where we're not running gyroMWD services somewhere in the globe. So with that, I'm going to move into a couple of case studies. And these are, you know, fairly typical applications that we're running with a high level of frequency. So the first case study here was the use of gyroMWD for collision avoidance on a congested pad in Australia. So this customer was drilling multiple top hole sections which were in close proximity and had under 10 meters of spacing between wells. So magnetic interference was present and the well was required to be kicked off from vertical in the correct direction. So the magnetic sensor in the MWD system, which was actually the scientific standalone system. So when we run gyroMWD, that probe-based tool also contains a magnetic sensor, and we will switch to that when we clear magnetic interference. So the kickoff point, the casing exit, sorry, our magnetic sensor was still inside casing and, of course, unable to provide accurate survey data. And this customer decided to run gyroMWD as opposed to installing a UBHO sub, which would be a universal borehole orientation sub in the BHA, and using a wireline conveyed gyro tool to provide the survey and the steering data. So this whole section was drilled with a bent mortar, and gyroMWD tool was picked up and aligned to the bend prior to running in hole. As I said, surface casing was set to vertical, and at the casing exit depth, gyroMWD tool was oriented to the desired azimuth, and the assembly was slid to kick off and build angle in the desired direction. GyroMWD surveys were taken frequently to ensure that the well was following the planned trajectory, and inclination and azimuth survey stations were provided until the switch to magnetic MWD data. So in this application and most applications, when the directional driller chooses, or we switch from gyro surveys to magnetic, it's common to have an overlap period where we receive data from both tools, and that allows directional confidence. So in this case, the operator was able to avoid 9 wireline runs, which at this depth would have taken around 45 minutes to rig up and rig down. So they saved hours of rig time and also benefited from reduced equipment and personnel costs on location. So moving on to a further typical example, and we have whipstock orientation in Deepwater Gulf of Mexico. So this well was drilled from a drill ship, and it required a whipstock to be set inside casing in order to sidetrack and recover a slot for increased production. So again, there was a requirement for orientation in the presence of magnetic interference, and the gyroMWD tool provided all relevant data until magnetic interference was cleared and the wellbore was successfully sidetracked. So we actually performed a number of these operations on this aging field, and again, the requirement for wireline was eliminated, and the customer able to recover the slot in the most efficient way without the need to stop drilling and run wireline or trip for secondary tools. So in these cases also, after the requirement for gyroMWD ends, we've cleared magnetic interference and drilling ahead on MWD data, the gyroMWD tool may remain in hole for the duration of the run. And in this case, it can either provide a second survey set for validation of the magnetic MWD, or can be put in a low power mode where it rides along or is also available as a backup in the BHA in case of any issue with the magnetics drilling ahead. Now, in the final case study, this was using a gyro MWD module system. And that's, again, where we're connected physically to a third-party MWD provider, their MWD system, and the telemetry is provided by them. SDI are on location to qualify data as it's received on surface. So this operator wanted to maximize spacing on the pad and required gyroMWD is a safety critical means of avoiding collision with offset wellbores. So as well as maintaining accurate wellbore positioning within their pad, they also, you know, required to avoid deeper offset wells. So accurate wellbore positioning at the casing exit allowed the planned trajectory to be met and allowed spacing for future well plans to be drilled and to remain within the lease lines there. So without gyroMWD on these applications, the operator would be kind of blind at the casing exit and drilling on inclination only. And in that case, there's the potential to kick off in the wrong direction, which best case would affect a future planned slot, or at worst case could allow a collision with an existing well. So gyroMWD module technology was used on a number of wells in this pad and others for the operator. And they were able to successfully kick off and drill wellbores in the planned trajectory. So to summarize, gyroMWD enables accurate wellbore placement. It's primarily used as for anti-collision in the case of magnetic interference. And that's wherever that magnetic interference may come from. It may be casing interference from offset wells. It might be casing interference from the current well, or from a hot BHA where there's insufficient magnetic spacing, We also see applications with magnetic formations or fluid systems, and of course it's used to sidetrack fish left in the hole. Further applications include survey validation and increased monitoring for gross error detection. And by obtaining gyro measurements from a tool which is already installed in the BHA, it's operationally efficient and cost-effective in terms of reducing rig time and personnel and equipment requirements on location. And that concludes everything on this brief, on this introduction to gyroMWD webinar. So I'd like to open the floor now. If anybody has any questions about gyroMWD, how the system works, anything at all, please ask away.
Hey, good morning, Lara. Yep. Thank you. Good morning, Lara.
Good morning.
Thank you for your presentation. A very good presentation. My name is Rubén Carrillo. I am from Plus Petrol, Argentina. And I would like to have I have this question. What is the range of inclination that this gyroMWD operates? It can operate up to 90 degrees, or it is limited to any inclination.
So the scientific drilling gyroMWD tool currently on the market has an inclination. I won't call it a limitation because it depends on the latitude of where you're drilling. But essentially, at higher latitude and higher inclination, the uncertainty increases. So we typically cite for our current commercial offering, we typically cite about 30 to 40 degrees of inclination as the maximum. And again, that depends on the latitude of where that wellbore is going to be drilled. We are in active development and active field testing of our next generation gyroMWD solutions, and they will be all inclination and all latitude tools.
Thank you, Laura.
Thanks, Laura. The next question from Claudio, what will be the battery life of the gyro?
So the battery life for a gyro, each gyro survey uses a very small amount of battery. It's taken over connection, so that uses about 4 minutes of battery total. Battery use is increased when you have a motor assembly and you're sliding on a gyro tool face. So in that case, if you were only sliding on gyro tool face and only taking gyro surveys with the pumps on, you would get 40 to 50 hours from the battery. And I know that doesn't sound like, maybe that doesn't sound like a lot, but when you break it down to the fact that you will rotate 2/3 of the stand and you'll probably be on a gravity or high side tool face within the first under 10 stands, I've never had to trip for a gyro battery, so we can take up to 100 surveys and drill for many hours, but it's it depends on your slide to rotate ratio if you're using a bent motor. If you're in a rotary steerable assembly, you will get more than 100 surveys out of the tool. So I hope that answers the question.
Great,
it's variable.
You.
Yeah.
Let's see, the next question from Indra, does SDI gyroMWD have limitation in a low temperature environment, i.e. less than 20 degrees Celsius?
Yeah, we actually in low temperature environments, we have the ability to run our gyro in a heat flask, and that's compatible with all of our systems, MudPulse, EM, Tandem, and third party modular systems. So in pre-job planning, we will discuss with the operator or the directional provider the wellbore conditions in terms of temperature. And if necessary, we will run a heat flask, which maintains the temperature of the gyro. We preheat it, and the gyro also generates heat downhole, which is captured within the flask. So we do operate in low temperature environments. I mean, we operate in seawater riserless environments with flasked gyros.
Thank you. Marissa has a comment that says, thank you, Laura. Very good presentation. We have successfully run your gyroMWD on 2 geothermal wells in Italy at the beginning of this year. So that's good. Let's see the next question from Edison. What's the minimum distance between wells or casing to avoid magnetic interference?
The minimum distance. I guess you could still expect to see magnetic interference depending on your orientation. I think up to 50 feet from the offset wellbore. Or the casing exit, yeah.
Okay, thank you. All right. Any other, let's see, is it possible to run the services with a third-party modular system with no SDI crew on location with remote support?
Yes, of course, you know, with COVID-19, more and more we're seeing remote operations has been a buzzword in the industry for a while, but you know, that's becoming more and more important with quarantine restrictions, etc., and personnel movement between countries. So yes, the third-party module systems lend themselves very well to remote operations. It's a question of communication and remote connection to the rig, and how we can view the data. So we have experience in it, and we are actively working on that. So with the third-party modular systems, we can work on that.
Perfect. Thank you. When will high angle tools be available, and what's the difference between those and the current gyro sensor?
So yeah, as I said, that project, we're actively in full field tests now. So we have a system that works. It works in our standalone system. We're working with our third-party providers to integrate with them. Right now, we're in the process of obtaining more and more runs so that we can validate the system. And we want to test it, exercise it, so that it's the most accurate, robust tool put out there. So the timeline, it's an engineering project. So, you know, we want to get it to the market as soon as possible, but we absolutely want it to be fit for purpose, ready to go, and accurate for our customers. So I don't want to give an exact timeline, but we're getting close, because we're really in the final stages of testing here.
Okay, thank you. Let's see, the next question from Andrew again. How long do we need to shut down pumps to get the directional survey?
On the current system, this is it's 4.5 minutes to take the survey, and that allows enough time for fluid movement to stop and for the tool to detect that. So the actual survey itself takes 2.97 minutes, but with the addition of the no flow detection, the pumps off total time is 4.5 minutes. And with the new system, we'll be looking at much more reduced system pumps off time, than that.
Okay, great. Any experience with gyroMWD in unconventional wells in Argentina?
Not that I am aware of, and not me personally.
Okay, but we can potentially, is that something we could potentially do if they're needed, I assume?
Absolutely. We have an operating partner down in Argentina, so you know, I'm not sure what equipment is there, but we are able to offer gyroMWD services in unconventional wells. So I just don't know of any specific operations. Yeah.
Yeah, we have gyros and we have MWDs in Argentina through our partnership. So that shouldn't be a problem, Karen. when run with EMMWD, can you take surveys with the pumps on?
No, because with the pumps on, the fluid's moving, and the gyro is north seeking and actively measuring the rotation of the earth. So it's incredibly sensitive to movement. So even on a low pump rate, it would still be too much kinetic noise, as we call it, for the tool. The timeline is optimized with EM, because with mud pumps, you know, we will wait until we're sure that the tool is finished taking the survey and we'll bring the mud pumps back on. With EM, we don't need to time anything. The tool, as soon as the survey has completed, will transmit it to surface, and the telemetry rate is very fast for EM. So.
Okay. Is the tool capable to run, this is from Max, is the tool capable to run on drilling with casing operations?
Yes, we have experience with drilling with casing operations, yeah, and with some of our third-party modular systems also.
Great. Is there any plan to set up the tools for just reduced flow for downleak instead of shut pump off? From Claudio.
Can you repeat that question, sorry?
Yeah, it's from Claudio, and the question is there any plan, is there any plan to set up tools for just to reduce flow for downleak instead of shutting pumps off? Or I'm assuming that means for survey.
Oh, for survey. No, again, with this gyroscope system, the keeper, any movement is too much movement. So, yeah, it would be a full pumps off. And we get that over connection, so.
Okay. Let's see. Rudy wants to know, when pumps on and waiting for full gyro survey comes up, can we reciprocate the string BHA up and down while waiting for a survey?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, the tool, as soon as the survey is completed, after that 4.5 minutes, it's stored to the tool memory. So say there was an issue and they didn't bring the pumps on for another 10 minutes. That's okay. The survey's still there. And equally, when you bring the pumps on, the pipe can be moved up and down or slowly rotated as required, because the survey is there. It would only be a case of if that was going to somehow interrupt the decoding of the telemetry. But yeah, slow movement of the pipe or any movement of the pipe will not affect the survey that is already taken and stored.
Okay, good. Second question from Rudy. Can we adjust the rate, the speed rate of the survey coming up? How, like, can you adjust how fast the full survey comes up?
Yeah, we can. And we can change our pulse widths, and we can actually program a number of pulse widths. So typically, if it's a new operation somewhere we haven't operated before, we'll go in with a medium pulse width that gives us a good chance of surface detection, because it's all about having strong pulses for mud pulse on surface, and the ability for our software to distinguish that pulse clearly and decode it. But we have high speed mud pulse available, and in that we can we reduce the pulse width and we increase the telemetry rate. And EM is incredibly easy to talk down and change the telemetry rate of that tool, because if it's talking to us through the formation, we can equally talk to it back through the formation without any effect on the rig, any need to cycle pumps or anything like that. We can talk directly to our tool downhole.
Okay, good. And so Rudy, there for your last comment, if your experience with our gyroMWD took 5 minutes for a full survey, that's probably just the way the operators set it up there. So we can, if you want to get in touch with Laura, we can definitely talk about how to speed that up for you a little bit if needed. Let's see, from Ivan, can the tool transmit continuous inclination while drilling?
Yes, the standalone gyroMWD system can transmit continuous inclination.
Okay, and from Santiago, thank you, Laura, for the presentation. So how many PSI increase in the system?
You mean pressure drop over the gyroMWD tool?
I would think so, yeah.
Yeah, I think it's negligible, really. It's about 60 PSI.
Okay.
It's never been...
Let's see, from Natalia, is the gyro retrievable in case you're stuck?
We do have a retrievable mud pulse and EM system, so that is an option. It's standard running gear would be non-retrievable.
Okay. Let's see, this question looks like, are there other new gyro, I guess this is a gyroMWD, are there other new gyroMWD tools on the market other than us and Gyro Data?
Yeah, there are a couple of operators who are looking into developing their gyro technology. I think, you know, our scientific drilling and gyro data are experienced gyro providers, and a gyro sensor is significantly different from an MWD sensor, but other parties are beginning to investigate the use of gyro MWD or adding it to their own suite. But like I say, scientific drilling, we have been offering this service for since 2000 in gyro MWD, and have experience with gyros for many years before that. So
right, good. So how do we reduce noise on offshore drill ships or in semi-submersibles to get good data?
Good data. So when you're drilling from a floating platform, as mentioned, any movement of the BHA can affect the survey quality. So of course, you know, the environmental conditions of being on a drill ship or a semi-sub can create movement. We were actually, the last two jobs I have been involved in are from drill ships. And we've been using the rig compensation system to take the surveys before connection. So isolating the BHA from movement at that point. We also find, you know, as we drill ahead, an angle is built on in the hole. When the tool begins to lay on the low side, that reduces movement of the BHA. So, you know, in vertical hole, we'll probably use the rig compensation systems. But as we get to above, I would say 5 to 10 degrees, and we start to lay on the low side, we can begin to take surveys over connection, depending on the environmental condition, how much movement is seen by the tool downhole.
Okay. And then can you elaborate on the tandem telemetry and how does that improve operations?
So tandem tool telemetry is for, say the directional provider was someone that we don't have modular compatibility with, and they wanted to run a suite of their own tools, their high tier resistivity, etc., for offshore applications. Their only options then, since we can't physically connect our gyro to their system, is to run a wireline conveyed gyro or to put a second mud pulse system in the BHA, and that would be scientific drilling's standalone. So you may have a third party's MWD tool close to the bit, and then in the non-mag straight above that tool, but not physically connected on any electrical or, you know, communication bus line, bullnosed off from each other, straight above the other MWD, you would have scientific drilling's gyro MWD tool. And we work with the other MWD provider in determining the frequency of their telemetry, and we offset our frequency from theirs. So typically we'll run at a lower frequency than them. And in that way, we'll set up, there'll be two standpipe transducers to detect the signal from our sensor and from their sensor, and we both decode on surface simultaneously. So that's one reason to run tandem is they want to run, you know, the directional provider's suite of you know, MWD, LWD tools, and we can't physically connect. And another reason is some operators just prefer the standalone system. And it's just another option to get a gyro in the BHA without running wireline.
Right. Let's see. Can both gyro and magnetic surveys be taken at the same time and transmitted real time to make sure that we are away from magnetic interference?
Yes. So a magnetic survey takes less time than a gyro survey. So it's captured they're captured at the same period. The gyro sensor is off taking its survey, and the magnetic sensor takes its survey and completes it before the gyro finishes. So we set the tool up typically where we know we're going to have magnetic interference. We can set it up to take gyro surveys only. Where we believe we're going to start to get clear, we set it by an inclination trip point. So if we think at 10 degrees inclination we'll start to clear magnetic interference, we'll program the tool to take both gyro and magnetic surveys at that point, and they're transmitted uphole at the same time. or we can have magnetic and gyro surveys for every survey point for the entire duration.
Okay, great. Let's see, any other questions, folks? All right, Laura, that looks like that's about it. So I want to thank everyone again for joining us this morning, this afternoon, this evening, and hope that we were able to give you a good overview of a gyroMWD system and what's required to get one to run. Please feel free to reach out to us if you have any questions. You can see Laura's contact information there on the screen. She will be very happy to be in contact with you if you have any other questions or need any, need to discuss any scenarios with her or anything along those lines. Want to remind you again, this webinar has been recorded, and we will be putting that out next week for everyone to view. Once we get this recording out, we will post it online and we'll make sure that you all get the link for it. If you need anything, please let us know. Thanks again for joining, and everyone stay safe.
Thank you, everyone. Have a good day.